Now, New Zealand's got some well-known names when it comes to movie making. Peter Jackson, Jane Campion, Taika Waititi.
But there's one name you may not know, and that's 93-year-old Fred Holloway of Masterton. Here's Julian Lee.
La, 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 la. Good afternoon. Let's put some stuff on. New power station. That one. That one I did. Closure of the Featherstone Court. Got permission to do it. What does it say?
It says Henley Trust, right. Type 1.
Now that's all of them. 4 years. I followed it right the way through. If I knew you was coming, I'd have baked a cake.
In this mighty collection, what's thought to be New Zealand's first ever colour news story, a marching competition.
Kane Kendall, sculptor, Keith Cairns, Maori, Biddeford Lake.
93-year-old Fred's seen it all, met them all, and he's only just been discovered by local videographer Phil Stebbing.
Policeman said to me one day, have you heard about we're going to build a new police station? Does anybody ask you it? You've done a lot of videos around town. I said, well, can I? Yes, with pleasure. And he was the chief of police, and he used to be a sergeant here. That's how he knew me.
That seems to be a common theme, just listening to you, that people seem to give you access to all sorts of places that others can't get. They obviously realised the value because you're documenting the history of the region.
That's right.
So you were 5 or 6 years old, your father was a film projectionist, and he bought you one to play with.
Yes, and it was as I say, it was a 35mm, which you can't see nowadays except big ones in the theatres.
As a child, Fred was in England when the Nazis started bombing. The authorities adopted him out to the countryside. The first film he saw, in fact, was about the war. San Demetrio, London, 1943. It inspired him. He trained as a projectionist.
And the guy said to me, can you join the film? Yes, I can, really. So he gave me a splicer. I said, I don't want that. What do you mean you don't want that? I said, watch. So he ripped the film for me. I put it on the desk, and scraped it, scraped the other side, got the cement, put it on. I don't believe this. Do it again. I did about 15 pieces.
I'm wondering if this is the only movie theatre in a sheep paddock in New Zealand, possibly the world.
Possibly.
It used to be the local telephone exchange.
Entrez-vous, monsieur.
Merci beaucoup.
Must be Rotorua. But it happens when the films get a bit old, they lose the green. Well, you watch. That's what it's missing.
Yeah.
The green.
If Fred's life was a movie, it would be a 5-hour epic. He lost his hearing while doing bomb disposal and lost his son at a young age.
As you say in the video industry, there's a lot of content there, isn't there?
He was even the local bailiff.
Dealing with murders and all that sort of stuff. You know, everyone from the gangs to the police, the ministers,
gangs,
the prime ministers.
Power. No, just behind me, a Rottweiler. And the woman says, what's the matter? I said, can you get somebody to get rid of this dog? Charlie, go down and get that dog. And the little kid comes running out. This big goes up to this Rottweiler, gets his collar and walks it back on. What do you do?
A kaleidoscopic arc of a story with all the colours of the rainbow. A tale with more twists and turns than a film noir. No wonder Fred likes a good flick. His own is the best watch of all.